A lie that is half-truth is the darkest of all lies. I spoke of over rupees 1,20,000 crore loot in IDBI Bank's name in the last video. Before Shakuni Mama rolls the dice on that story, he has four small interesting ones which mainstream media won't tell you. That starts with guided tour of Finance Ministry. Now Shakuni's dilemma. Should Madam address country's economic slum or grasp the complexities of her ministry? His dilemma is relevant. Madam has new problem on her hands. Revenue collection is expected to fall short by about rupees 3 lakh crore from budget estimate. You tell me, sir, whom should she ask why? Will it be the team that projected revenue numbers, or the team that projected expenditure figures, or the team that supervised the collection, or the team that supervise the expenditure? Team has sub-teams, all are domain experts, all give expert responses to Madam's query. Responses rub against one another and lose their original shape. Result, Madam will get lot of noise, but no answer. In the resultant noise, this happens. Now, if you want to question which are the steps taken to address which issues, or which all cars government bought to solve economic slowdown, whom will you ask? But these are higher level conceptual decisions. Mating of elephants happens at high level. Taxpayers level, stay there. Finance minister says she is open to ideas. But you tell me, sir, in this expert atmosphere that she works from, how will ideas reach her? This year's budget speech and proposals have taken conceptual level decisions to a new high. Madam is supposed to have simplified personal tax system wherein, in her own words, taxpayers could file returns without help of experts. But read the fine print. You will see, welcome to a most complicated taxation system. If earlier I needed help of one expert, with a new system wherein old will coexist with the new, I will need help of two experts. Let me call out the convoluted mind of the bureaucracy and failure of political bosses to see through their sham. Exemption of tax on portion of housing loan repayment was introduced to help people buy houses. Interest subvention scheme was introduced to push budget housing. Now income tax rates are reduced to leave more disposable income in the hands of same people. But if you want more income, you won't get housing loan exemption benefit. So what is the net gain to middle class, and how will it push people to spend more to help revive the sagging economy? Madam said government will respect wealth creators. Company promoters' dividend income will now be taxed at highest slab, while foreign investors will continue to get tax benefit. To whom are we showing respect, madam? Another example. Government wants more money, so it'll sell some share of LIC to public. Look at the way a budget proposal destroys the value of LIC before sale, and how. Tax benefits on buying insurance policies are removed, means reduced sale of policies, means reduced business, lower valuation of LIC. With this low valuation, government expects to collect more money. What a terrible way to do business. Madam's mail to me for the ideas I sent to PMO at the time of preparing the budget. Shakuni's query: who regulates Indian banking? Before the experts answer, why don't you answer, sir? Shakuni says previous RBI governor Mr. Urjit Patel resigned when God told him that he can't answer this question in his lifetime. Now the good news: RBI recently said its supervisory mechanism is robust. Doesn't matter, companies keep collapsing like DHFL, Reliance Home Finance, ILFS due frauds. Doesn't matter, ED, CBI investigate because of whistleblowers, not because of RBI. This robust must be robust plus when it comes to FinMin's supervisory mechanism, because FinMin sits higher. See, Mumbai is at 14 meters, Delhi 216 meters. We all know FinMin and RBI contradict each other on responsibility and accountability for regulation and supervision of PSU banks. To make matters worse, FinMin officials are board members in PSU banks. If NBFC sector is mired in frauds, how healthy are PSU banks? Robust plus plus. In this intentionally created madness, who regulates whom? What can be robust in such a dysfunctional anarchy? Lakhs of crores of rupees have been siphoned off from banks. Has any investigation in any of the scams pinned the blame on Finance Ministry or RBI? No way. With no accountability, government and RBI continue to play ping pong. As I speak, government banks continue to lose 23 paisa for every rupee that is invested, while private banks earn 9.6 paisa. Government earns about 2 paisa tax without investing a single penny on this. What a tragic financial management. Against this backdrop, I couldn't believe my ears when Madam announced in budget speech that government will take appropriate measures to strengthen the banks. See the play of bureaucrats. What are the appropriate measures? Not a word about removing the ambiguity on duality of control, the charade of investigations of frauds, of eyewash annual inspections with unabated frauds. God is surely right. In the game of dice, we can disrupt Shakuni even before he blinks his eye. That's how well we have mastered the game. Not surprisingly, banking system has to implode. PSBs will continue to remain unguided missiles. Come sir, join the government and sing. But we might as well kiss goodbye to a 5 trillion economy. Original sins. I have covered bureaucracy's love for babies in 2 videos. This baby is unique. Printing of notes was exclusive domain of RBI. B went to work and produced SPMCIL in 2006. Why this new baby under FinMin? Shakuni's take. The then existing fiscal liquidity was not enough to adequately lubricate the ecosystem that had adversely affected ease of doing business. Liquidity crunch was felt by the then fulcrum. In simple words, if UPA had policy paralysis, did RBI have printing paralysis that affected easy business? Okay, ease of doing business? Hence the baby. For appropriate, articulate, scholarly, respectable response, the then Honorable Finance Minister will have to be asked. SPMCIL fake notes in circulation, De La Rue a UK company's link. And Modi's demonetization is a separate story beyond the scope for today.
If you have near perfect counterfeit currency getting fed into your currency system, in 2011, a ship came from Dubai carrying containers full of counterfeit currencies, 500 rupees and 1000 rupee notes. Each container was close to 5000 crores. But people in the knowledge tell me that they were close to 100 such containers that came in. Mr. Chidambaram goes and buys paper from the same place that Pakistan is buying.
Sri Iyer mentioning same place is De La Rue company that I spoke of. Retired DGP Sen Kumar at Sri Iyer's book launch function said, circulation of counterfeit currency exploded in Kerala from 2006. The year SPMCIL, an additional printing press was delivered by the then FinMin. Fourth story in original sins. The simple structured FinMin had set divestment target of rupees 1.05 lakh crore in 1920 budget. New year, new resolution. Sale of BPCL, Air India and Container Corp, ab nahi hota ma'am. But why? As per an official, we encountered surprises once wheels began to move. April to Jan, 10 months to move. Alert Modi government got surprised by lazy surprise. But this encountered surprises theory surprises me, because in October 18, when ILFS, a private company, was adopted, no surprises, only sweet smiles were encountered by bureaucrats. So with rupees 1 lakh crore plus dues, adoption was done and dusted in under 15 days. You can watch this video for full story, link given in description. As if to confirm the contents in that video, new budget has given special exemption to Abu Dhabi Investment Authority, an investor in ILFS, and this portion was not part of budget speech. So I don't know whether Madam or Modi is aware of this sleight of hand of the bureaucrats. Modi may want minimum government. We will keep adding to maximum government. Consider Air India's case. Cabinet decision to sell was in 2017. Baby's intestines still expel surprises. Ouch! Surprises are real slow and lazy. This lazy story is in pipeline. Governance is simply out of syllabus. In short, ILFS from private to government company in mere 15 days? Yes! PSUs, public to private?
Are you serious?
Every day Air India is losing money. With this new spoke, do you think any bidder will come? Modi can worry and therefore warn bureaucrats not to waste his second term. But you and me, let's get real. Budgeting is higher level stuff. It's an exercise of projecting numbers. If Modi's term gets spoiled, it is perception problem, not that of projection of numbers. Other day, that fake TV news channel reported that due to this fiscal math going topsy-turvy year after year, budget committee has decided that jalebis will be cooked in North Block in place of halwa. Since budget numbers, the jalebis all same same. Jalebi idea looks perfect. The same official who encountered lazy surprise to delay divestment declined to comment on impact of such events on fiscal math. When my job is secure, pay comes irrespective of job performance. How the hell am I concerned with what impact my inefficiency and non-performance has on the economy? Now government has to cut spending. This will hurt the crippled economy further. Price you and me pay. Surprise stink and pollution is still in the air. No problems. If we are not happy enough with the story, take this 2.1 lakh crore disinvestment target in this budget. Next winter, Delhi will have more surprises and therefore increased pollution. North Block will cook salted jalebis next year. Through this budget, Team Modi has failed him. Against this reality, how am I to buy into this high level, yes, the same one, conceptual 5-year projection story? That is rupees 20 lakh crore per year. Where is the money, honey? He is going around with a stick in his hand. Show some numbers to him now. We can always spin a new story of encountered surprises later. Modi may be keen to move beyond gradual moves. Fine print in any policy is what kills it in the end. Who will monitor that? Thus, Shakuni's original theory. The original sins flow from here. Is Shakuni right? Type in your comments. To address this challenge, Modi has to put a price for accountability on the table by amending part 14 of the Constitution. Time is running out, Modi ji. These two headlines, unrelated to main story, home into the same subject. A judge had to be told, Please recuse yourself, Your Honor, in this Karthi Chidambaram's case. You were advocate for Strategic Advantage Consultancy earlier. How did the case get listed to her bench? Modi's insolvency bill is to catch loan defaulters. Now CBI has to additionally arrest resolution professionals. Bureaucracy has created such a fertile ground where every tree produces money fruits in abundance. If you are convinced of the four small stories of Shakuni, share this video for maximum people to watch. Also tweet to PM Modi, it won't even take 5 minutes of yours. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't. Scroll down cell phone screen and comment here, a small reciprocation for a friend. Kiran Stasi, Financial Times journalist, last year wrote, "In my 16 months, nothing has encapsulated the often comically absurd nature of India's bureaucratic rules as much as my last visit to Foreigners Regional Registration Office. Why are my charges so high? The bill for my newborn son's first Indian visa, that sir, is your visa fee, and below that, £100 is your fine. When I asked what I was being fined for, he said calmly, 'You did not get a visa within 14 days of your son's arrival.' But he was born in India, and it would have been impossible to get him a visa within 14 days of being born. It takes several months to get him a passport. Yes, sir, but these are rules. What can I do? Paperwork is the embalming fluid of bureaucracy, maintaining an appearance of life where none exists." Jai Hind.